So from algorithm description, we go to implementation now. This is where rubber meets the road in systems research. In any good systems research, the prescription is as follows. You identify a pain point. Once you identify the pain point, you think of what may be a clever solution to that. Then a lot of heavy lifting actually happens in taking that solution, which may be a very simple solution, but implementing that is the hard part. If you take this particular lesson that we are looking at, the solution idea is fairly simple. The idea is that instead of using the disk as a paging device, use a cluster memory. But implementing that idea requires quite a bit of heavy lifting. And one might say that in systems research, these technical details of taking an idea and working out the technical details of implementing that idea is probably the most important nugget. Even if the idea itself is not enduring, the implementation tricks and techniques that are invented in order to do that implementation of that idea may be reusable knowledge for other systems research. So that's a key takeaway in any systems research, and it is true for this one as well. Now, in this particular case, the authors of GSM used a DEC, Digital Equipment Corporation's operating system as the base system. The operating system is called OSF1 operating system. And there are two key components in the OSF1 memory system, which is what we're talking about here. The first one is the virtual memory system. And this is the one that is responsible for mapping processed virtual address space to physical memory and worrying about page faults that happen when a process is trying to access its stack and heap and so on, so that it can bring those missing pages perhaps from the disk. And these pages are sometimes referred to as anonymous pages because a page is housed in a physical page frame, and when a page is replaced, that same physical page frame may host some other virtual page and so on. So the virtual memory system is devoted to managing the page faults that occur for process virtual address space, in particular the stack and the heap. And the unified buffer cache is the cache that is used by the file system. And remember that file system is also getting stuff from the disk. But the file system wants to cache it in physical memory so that it is faster. So the unified buffer cache is serving as the abstraction for the disk resident files when it gets into physical memory. And user processes are going to do explicit access to files. When they do that, they're actually accessing the unified buffer cache. So reads and writes of files go to this unified buffer cache. In addition to that, Unix systems offer the ability to map a file into memory, which is called memory mapped files. And if you have a memory mapped file, you can also have page faults to a file that has been mapped into memory. So the unified buffer cache is responsible for handling page faults to mapped files, as well as explicit read and write calls that an application process may make to the file system. So normally, this is the picture of how the memory system hangs together in any typical implementation of an operating system. You have the virtual memory manager, you have the unified buffer cache, you have the disk, and reads and writes from the virtual memory manager go to the disk, and similarly, reads and writes from the unified buffer cache go to the disk. And when a physical page frame is freed, you throw it into the free list so that it is available for future use by either the virtual memory manager or the unified buffer cache. And the page out daemon, its role is to look at every once in a while what are pages that can be swapped out to the disk so that you make room for page faults to be handled without necessarily running an algorithm to free up pages. So that's the structure of a memory management system. And what the authors of GMS did was to integrate GMS into the operating system. And this is where I said that there is heavy lifting to be done, because you are modifying the operating system to integrate an idea that you had for global memory system.